Donald Glover dies on Hot Ones, says, please listen to the album. Like, you know.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? For First We Feast, I'm Sean Evans, and you're watching Hot Ones. It's the show with hot questions and even hotter wings. And today we're joined by Donald Glover, aka Childish Gambino. He's a 5-time Grammy Award-winning artist as well as an Emmy Award-winning actor and director. Earlier this year, he re-released his album 2015-20 under the name Atavista. And on July 19th, he's dropping his final album under the Childish Gambino name. It's called Bando Stone and the New World, which will be accompanied by a short film.
Bro, if you had not checked out this album yet, you really missing out, bro. This man got Yeet on the feature, bro. That's really like the best song on there.
World Tour. Donald Glover, welcome to the show.
How's it going?
I'm doing good, if you're doing good.
I'm doing pretty good. This does feel shamanic.
Mm.
Feels pretty intense already. Like, I feel like I'm about to do ayahuasca. Like, this is... Oh, yeah, I'm ready, though. I'm ready.
Oh, hell.
Definitely gonna see myself. I think it's gonna be a very reflective episode.
Man, I'm not eating chicken, bro.
This is too hot. He's already too hot. This is starting way hotter than, I mean, I like hot stuff, but like I'm understanding the spectrum. Too hot for the beginning, but it's fine. It's fine.
I love hot wings.
So earlier this year, you announced that you'd be releasing Atavista and added, after that, there's the final Childish Gambino album, a soundtrack for the fans. How or why did you know that this would be the end?
I mean, like, a collaborator of mine, like, Fam and I, like, we talked about, like, the death of Superman a lot. Like, he always brought up the death of Superman. He's always kind of loved that. I always knew, like, Childish Gambino was, like, a character. On some level, I wanted it to end. I feel like the Childish Gambino character is almost like the boss from The Office. It's like, yeah, that worked 10 years ago. You know, like that worked.
It's still working, bro.
But now it's like a different thing. Like, it's like, oh, it's a little sad, but it's also like, wow, like the cycle kind of continues, which is great.
Bro, that shit's sad as fuck. I'm gonna miss his music. We acting like he dead.
Singing double. Oh, with the two chilies.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's see how this goes. Oh, I like that one. I like that one.
And maybe even a little less hot than the first one.
It's got more flavor, which is all I need. It's more of a vinegar,
mm-hmm.
like kind of flavor.
Right up your alley.
I prefer. It's good. I prefer that. All right, cool. All right, we're okay.
We're okay. Back. Back on solid ground. We're back on
time. Yeah.
I'm
at the beginning of the vision quest. I'm seeing like a coyote's like... Like, kind of mean, so it's good.
Your music video for Littlefoot Bigfoot is incredible. Can you draw back the curtain on what it's like to collaborate with someone like Shay on the choreography? It happens, you know, to be equal parts, you know, you, him, and the 1920s.
That song was crazy.
I feel like it's hard to make a dance video that is just dance. Like, there's not like, you know, crazy stuff happening. It's just like, these are just dancers who are really good at dancing. And I was just really impressed. And I was like, I really want to do this like Cab Calloway vision. And he really dug in and molded it to what I naturally like to do. And like, it was good. It was really hot in that room. I just remember that. It's in, you know, it was a hot one.
Corny.
Kimchi, I love kimchi.
I low-key hate kimchi.
Y'all don't notice, but it's 9 a.m.
In the morning?
That's 9 a.m.
I'd like to announce and officially make it a part of the record. Mm-hmm. The earliest Hot One shoot in the history of the show.
You know, I try and do something different every time, you know, for everything. This was definitely it. And I was like, let me get this poop out, you know, by lunch.
Right, have the rest of your day.
Yeah, the rest of my day to do this, yeah. That one was good.
So I think if there were ever a place to deconstruct the chicken wing, it's on this show, talking to you. What does the lemon pepper wing mean to you? And then how would you best describe its cultural impact?
I gotta be honest, like, I don't understand it. Like, I mean, like, when we did Atlanta and we had the joke about the lemon pepper wet, you know, it was just like, it's just, it was literally just a silly joke. Like, if you like a really sloppy, wet wing, you're gonna want the hot wing. But if you want a dry, crunchy wing, you're probably gonna want the lemon pepper. So like, the idea of combining them was just a stupid, silly idea of like, my mind can't handle it. But what was
That's crazy, a crazy idea, though.
We did that at JR Crickets, and then they made the lemon pepper wet.
Right.
Which I was like, is that even possible? It's like that metal that's like liquid in your hand, but when you put it down, it's like a cube, like a little bit. It's like, I didn't know culturally that it would take on that kind of life or that people even cared that much. But that was the whole Atlanta experience, to be honest, like to make that. It was a really good lesson in not worrying about the destination and just enjoying the journey, really.
It's like you're setting me up for these segues.
Oh, yeah. You know? I'm AI generated. I did a lot of, you know, Sean work before this.
Well, are you ready to continue on this journey?
Yeah.
All right, so this next one is the Los Calientes Barbacoa.
Okay. You guys made this one, too. It says hot one.
Yeah, but if you don't like it, let us know, you know?
No, I mean... Wow. This one's kind of sweet.
I'm sure it's probably really going to be that hot.
I like that one.
Oh, it's a heat level 4.
This has just enough sweet for you to be like, okay, this is good. It was delicious. There we go.
Got to throw their promo in there.
During your appearance on The Shop, you told this story about how you created the album, Awaken My Love, as a way to prove someone wrong when they said that you couldn't make a hit.
Yeah.
And I'm curious, how, if at all, does the spirit of being petty serve you creatively?
It's almost like the dark art. It's like a dark art where it's like, it's something you need or maybe experience when you're young. Because I don't need that as much anymore. Sometimes I do it, sometimes I'll read a review to get myself, like, because it's, I feel like you want to get to a point, like, by the time you're in your That's 70s true. Or 80s, you know, God willing, you want to be like, oh, anger. This is fun, I remember that, like a little bit. Because I'm like, yeah, like, it's not, it doesn't really serve you as well as you want. That feeling never quite goes away. You want people who you think are cool to like it and all that kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, you really do have to sit back and be like, at a certain point, be like, I know how to make music. I know how to make interesting choices. And I have a flavor. And here's the flavor.
Whoa, come on.
How do you know to say these type shits, bro?
Maybe
you're too smooth, bro.
Like, I think I'm pretty good at this.
He's a good talker, bro. All that shit he say is so true.
This is Fat Cat. All right. It's got like that sneaky spice, but it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
And the step up over here, nothing you can't handle.
Yeah, it's a step up, but it's actually not as hot as I thought it was going to be.
Hmm. Was there anything that was considered a best practice in the writers' rooms of, say, The Daily Show or 30 Rock that you threw out the window once you were running your own writers' room with Atlanta?
The one thing I didn't want to run on, even though I had a great time, I had such a great time at 30 Rock and, like, you know, writing for those shows, and, like, it was a great time. But one thing at 30 Rock that I didn't want as much of, because I feel like it was kind of a thing from SNL, was, like, fear. Like, writer's room's a scary place. People, you know, like, I remember one time I came into the 30 Rock room and I had a new hat on. I just had a hat, and they came in and someone, one of the writers goes, hat. And it was just, I couldn't wear the hat. Like, it was just too, it was because they're just funny. Like, people, funny people. I was like, you're right, I was trying something new. I'm ashamed, like, kind of thing. So I was like, yeah, I just didn't want any fear in my room because I was like, if we're trying
ever,
to
bro.
Make a show for somebody else, we're fucked. So everything I've ever made is just like something I would watch. Like, you can't make it for somebody else. It starts to pick up here, right? Doesn't it? I can smell this one's hot.
Mm-hmm.
You can smell it just from the smell. Damn, this is a pickup. This is a pickup. All right. I mean, because this is like, I don't want to wipe my eyes. Now I'm scared, you know, that kind of thing.
I'll be on it. You know what I mean? That's the biggest mistake guests make on this show.
Really?
But going back in.
This is how Stevie Wonder went blind, right? He was like the hot ones in 1958.
Yeah.
Touched his eyes.
You know, we don't like to talk about that over here. Right?
Yeah.
Still some,
I mean, but he,
still
hey,
some pending litigation.
It kind of made him. No.
So the standard comedic impulse is self-flagellation, while the prevailing rap posture is one of braggadocio. Are those things ever in conflict with you as someone who's explored both genres so heavily?
That's a good question. I think that's probably been the hardest part on some level as far as like people understanding, which is why I kind of chose to like, oh, character path. I don't want to be the king, and I also don't have to be the peon. Like, I'm the joker in the court. I get to do what I want. Like, I was like, this is not rap attire by any means, like, you know, in if you that really, idea, but I also...
If you really know Childish Gambino, bro, he does whatever his heart feels like, bro. Bro, he goes off vision, bro. Imagination, and it's beautiful every time. Like, I just don't know. That's a beautiful mind. I
also feel like, yeah, there needs to be an alternative. You know, that was the kind of idea, I think, in general, is being like, yeah, or you can do this, and it may not be your jam, but at least you know there's like, an alternative. All right, let's do it.
Kind of a sweetness at first, yeah.
Prickly in the back.
Prickly in the back.
There was like a red storm, like a Jupiter red storm on it, and I bit on it, and I was like, that was stupid.
You saw a storm cell.
I saw, yeah.
Right on the wing and went
right on the wing, and I was like, no, that must be good to eat.
Respect. We're on the journey,
we're still on the journey. I wonder, I'm starting, not the coyote's like, now, he's just like, he's like, jump in the pit, and I'm like, he's like, you must, like, kind of, for your fathers. You're all your fathers.
Follow the coyote, he'll bring us home.
Yeah.
You know?
It actually, yeah, this feels good. It's all good.
Can you discern a difference between a Donald Glover and a Childish Gambino fan when you see them on the street? Like, is there a noticeable polarity between, you know, a fan who's drawn to you for your acting versus one who's drawn to you for your music?
Yeah, I feel like there, usually it's weirdly, it started like regionally.
Mm.
Like, if I was in Canada, you were a community fan. Like, you were a community fan. Like, you're doing that, come on, we gotta do the shake thing. And then, you know, if I was at a college, you're a Childish Gambino fan. Why'd you stop rapping, man? You need to start rapping again. Like, that was a lot of that. I feel like older skewed started listening to me, like, Awaken My Love, but also, like, Atlanta. People have a story of what stuff means. So I feel like sometimes just splitting it up and allowing that to happen is better for it. But yeah, people now just all are like, oh, it's Donald, which is good.
I'm going crazy.
All right, let's do it. All right.
The ball.
Let's see where the coyote takes us this time.
He ain't even want to take a big bite.
Mm-mm. Damn.
You bet.
I don't like that.
But enough to go in for another bite.
Because I gotta
really
show
feel
up.
It.
I gotta really feel it. Damn. No, I'm fine. That was really hot.
Just when you think you're past it, it just keeps growing inside of you, you know?
Wow.
Surprised they ain't taking nothing to drink yet.
Okay, yeah, now the coyote's like, yeah, how is it? That's when it face your fear. Like,
I'm
like,
hiccuping right now.
He's like on a... he has one eye now. He's like got the Thanos glove on. And you know...
the coyote?
Whoa. I am seeing things. God, this
I think
wild.
That you're actually seeing this coyote.
This I am seeing this guy. This is wild. Oh, he wants me to make up with my cousin.
What?
Talk to him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I did that to you. I didn't mean to hurt you. We were six. I don't want to drink the milk because I don't want to be like a punk. But
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Damn,
but it
like,
is inviting at a time like this.
Yeah. All right.
What's your proudest achievement?
Oh, man, drunk that shit.
I just saw, just all I heard you say was fire, fire, fire. I just saw you literally just go, so fire, fire, you're on fire, fire, so fire, fire. Like, that's what
got,
it felt like.
You've got avocados growing out there.
Uh-huh.
You've got an orange growing
avocados,
out there.
That would be a lot of fat. That would be good for my mouth. Whew. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Do you have a proudest achievement as a produce grower out there?
Mulberries.
Mulberries?
Yeah, we have mulberries, and I'm very proud of them. They're, like, delicious, but they're only good for, like, 2 or 3 weeks. Where am I? Like, what is this? What am I doing?
What's a Tangelo?
Oh, Tangelo is like a, it's almost like, I love Tangelos because they're kind of sour and they have like, they're orange, but they're kind of a deeper orange. Like a,
what is a Tangelo?
And they peel so easily. Like, it's almost like the thing is hanging in between. So you just pop it and it's like, it's just holding it. So they're really easy to peel. And they're like tangerines, but a little more sour. They're my favorite. They're my favorite. Wow. You're eating it like you've never had it.
It's, I told you, it's a singular experience.
Holy moly.
And every time I go through that shit, it's like the first time.
But
over
you didn't,
and over
you also
again.
Didn't touch the milk. I feel like you
didn't touch the milk.
You should do what you really
no,
do.
No,
man.
I want to share the experience.
Okay.
As Donald Glover experiences it.
I, man.
You know?
Whew. Oh my gosh. I'm seeing like plateaus right, of
he's
like.
He's sweating a little bit at the top.
Arizona and shit. This is awesome. Okay. All right. I just got over that last one.
That's the experience of Hot Ones. You know, the storm clears, the sun comes out, and then the dark clouds start to roll in again.
I'm sorry, this is like, it's making me laugh, it's so painful. This shit is crazy. All right, let's do it. This one's called Peppers Up. It has a dead person, a skull, eating a chili. Just so you guys know, like, most of the time when you see a picture like this, it means this man is in jail for life and it's on, it's tattooed on his head. But this is a hot sauce. For us, I guess we're gonna eat this.
It just invites the next bite.
That's a bad sign. The first, when it starts sweet.
Right. And there's nothing fun about it?
Come on.
You say, come on.
Come on.
But easier than the last one.
Oh my gosh. If I have another kid, it's gonna come out on fire. Jeez, that is. It does feel like ayahuasca.
Listen.
He don't want to eat that one no more.
I've been doing this long enough that every once in a while, and I'm catching it right now.
You get a high?
I get a head high.
Yeah.
A sort of weightlessness feeling.
Yeah.
And it's nice. Euphoric, and I like it. And it doesn't happen every episode, but when it does, I kind of like to lean into it.
No, I love it. I'm definitely getting it too. It feels like a runner's high almost, like a little bit, where I'm just like, but also like we're in this like weird nebulous space. Like it's all black. Like I'm just kind of like, where am I? Like, oh my God, I'm alive.
Like, when you showed up today, you did walk in this and you were like, oh yeah, this is Hot Ones.
Yeah, because it is iconic because there's nothing else. And you would think like the rest of the room is like, it's like, nope. It kind of reminds me of the Eric Andre show. Everybody's acting a little scared already. And then they bring their like, oh, Donald Glover, you come out, no audience, dead silence.
This show is kind of the same way because you have this long, even nebulous hallway.
I can't see anything. Like, all your friends are, like, there, but they're not looking at you. They're looking at the screen.
Them.
Where it's, like, almost feels like feels like heaven or something where, like, the board is like, he should go to hell. Like, this isn't. I can't believe what he did. No, this is good. Wow. That one actually not as bad as the other one.
I told you. You know, it ends up doing a thing.
Yeah, not bad.
De bomb where... As painful as it is,
yeah, I'm on some chicken wings right now.
Yeah,
for the rest of the episode.
I'm hungry.
This is shamanic. This is awesome. I actually like it being hotter with this thing on too. Yeah. I'm like, ooh, yeah.
Cozy,
like, I'm
like, in a comfortable spot.
I would have been take that off. I would
so
just
this
sweating.
Is the last dab. We call it the last dab because it's tradition around here to put a little extra on the last one. You don't have to if you don't want to.
Nah, are we doing this or we doing this?
We doing this.
All right. Who started that tradition?
Machine Gun Kelly, believe it or not.
And y'all were like, we gotta do this again.
MGK.
Is this a good amount?
How much? That's very healthy right there.
Oh, okay.
Cheers.
Cheers.
What a run.
Cheers. To the coyote gods.
To the coyote gods. Ow! Ow!
Okay. I can tell this one's gonna be hot, but...
Girl,
here's the key to the last one.
Mm-hmm.
By this point... You know it's gonna be okay. That's what's crazy about it.
This whole thing has been a spiritual journey, you know?
It does feel like it's like, okay, yeah, da, da, da. And then you get to something where you're like, I can't do this. And then you get through it and you're like, oh, I can do fucking anything. I could drink this, you know? No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm kidding. Kidding, y'all.
Hell no.
Donald Glover dies on Hot Ones, says, please listen to the album. Like, you know.
And we'll close actually with an existential thought exercise. You know, you're closing the book on this part of your creative journey, on this part of your artistic journey.
Yeah.
And I'm curious how you think the music alter ego will walk into the sunset. Does this moment give you any sort of clarity on, you know, who Childish Gambino is and what it all means?
The Childish Gambino story, I think from the Wu-Tang Clan, like RZA told me, like this. He was like, it's a story of a child turning into a boss, or like, he was like, you know, Childish Gambino kind of thing. He's like, this last sunset walk is really about, like, this is for the fans. This is for you. If this isn't the best live show you've ever seen, after the first song, if you're like, yeah, this is, I gotta go, you can leave and I will give you your money back. That's how much I care about all of this. That's not like a joke. My lawyers will be like, it's a joke, but it's not a joke. You can actually, I will set it up so you can go. This was really actually good. Can I rate these?
Yeah, actually, go ahead. I'd love that.
This wasn't tasty, but it changed my life.
Is that eight?
That's eight. That's the really spicy one. That's the bomb. So like the bomb, if you want to like,
it has an exalted place.
Yeah. If you want to do ayahuasca light.
That boy still ain't drink no milk. That shit must not be that hard.
The most flavorful one, I really like kimchi. Kimchi was really great. The barbacoa, Black Horse. I did not realize this one. I was like, oh, man. Sweet. And then I was like, this one is actually really, really, really good. And the classic was great.
Look at you, Donald Glover, taking on the wings of death, living to tell the tale, and now there's nothing left to do but roll out the red carpet for you. This camera, let the people know what you have going on in your life.
I have an album coming out tomorrow when this comes out. It'll probably be out like by the time you're watching this. Please go see that. Go see the show. Come see the live show. That'll be really fun. I'm really excited about all of this. But also, I think I wouldn't take this time to say, Shane Gillis, I beat you, fair and square.
Not Shane.
I saw you ate this and you fell apart under pressure. So I just want to tell you, like, yeah, I'm coming for you when we do this again in 10 years. Yeah.
Round of fucking applause, man.
I started getting floods of memories of stuff, of like other hot shit. You know, like Community, first season. I like really looked up to Joel, and Joel was like literally like only eating espressos and eggs. Like that was it, like literally, because he wanted to get in shape. He had like a shirt off scene, and literally he was like, oh, hot sauce. He's like, hot sauce will help you. Like it's the only flavor you can really like, hot sauce. So I started putting hot sauce in everything, and then we started getting into like a thing with each other. And I realized like, oh yeah, that must have like boosted my tolerance, because I just remember just putting tons of hot sauce on like eggs.
It all led to this moment.
It was all for that.
Awesome. Yeah. That was, I don't know about awesome. That.
No, that was good. That was great.
Hey, what's going on, Hot Ones?
Dang, that's it for the video, man. Childish Gambino just ate some hot ass wings. But if you didn't already, bro. You really missing out. Like, I know I'm like a couple of weeks late on this, but the album already out, bro. Go check that out. And like I said, Crushing is the best song on the album right now, bro. Literally. But y'all ain't know what to do, man. Subscribe to the channel. Make sure you drop down in the comments below on something you want to see. Let me know what you think about the video. Y'all there.